This world is not my home. I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I have a loving mother just over in Glory Land, and I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me in heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Just over in Glory Land we'll live eternally. The saints on every hand are shouting victory. Their songs of sweetest praise drip back from heaven's shore, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. When my way groweth drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me on. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. My work is all done, and my race here is run. Let me see by the light thou hast shone. That fair city so bright, where the lamp is the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me on. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I'm weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
What?
Stars are watching the world as it sleeps. Shepherds watch over the little white sheep. The lighthouse is shining for ships far at sea, as God keeps the night watch for you and for me. So sleep, sleep in peace and rest. Don't be afraid of the darkness. All's well for over the land and the sea. God's
I saw, I redeemed my liberty. In an age as then, that the love of day, upon the earth. And though after my skin, from the strong, this body yet in my flesh, shall I see God. recognize family members that are present here. Please, all those that are related to our daddy, the children, grandchildren, in-laws, please, can you be upstanding? We want to welcome you into the church. Please, all family members, can you be upstanding, please? Please, I will celebrate God for your life. Let's be nice prayer for God. You are all welcome, especially our family, the wife of our leader, you are welcome in Jesus' name. Please, can you be seated? And after my instruction, I'm going to be recognizing just very few persons, because we have an array of dignitaries that are here because of personalities. And joining me, welcome Reverend Dr. Jonathan Iwibu. That is the president of the Baptist family here in Ethiopia Delta Baptist Conference. That is the CP of the Baptist Conference in Ethiopia Delta. Then let's to the present conference president. We have the immediate past president. Then it was Edo, the whole of Delta, brother. Delta is actually 32-3. And he was the president representing the whole of Delta at that time. I'm talking about no other person but Reverend Gideon Oyibo, the immediate past grand chairman of Delta State also. Our daddy, you are welcome. We have the minister in charge of this church. He's no other person than Reverend L.O. Ogbonigo. He's here in our midst. Please, can we celebrate our reverend? We also have the associate pastor of the church officiating today also. He's no other person than Reverend E.C. Obara. Please, can we celebrate our reverend? Also here this morning that is still on the officiating list is no other person than Reverend Mrs. B.O. Egureju. Please, can we celebrate? All the time. Still officiating today is no other person but Engineer Deacon F.A. Itaro here in our midst. Please, can we celebrate our reverend? You're welcome. Also officiating today in our midst is another reverend, Reverend Dr. Ajagbe, all the way from Ebenezer Baptist Church. Please, can we celebrate our reverend? Also, this morning we'll be having another officiating personnel all the way from Ogenetega Baptist Church. That is Praise Baptist Church. It's no other person than Reverend Jesa. He will be in our midst very soon. He's not here. There's officiating here this morning. Please, the man of God that will be giving us the message today is all the way from Ugele. I'm talking about Bishop Damo Emobo. Please, can we celebrate our daddy? Our bishop, you're welcome. You're welcome to Bethel Baptist Church. Please, the list is endless, as I've instructed that shouldn't go more than that are officiating today. Please, all ministers of the gospel that are in the house, can you be upstanding? If you are a pastor in the house, please, all our bishops, and we are sorry, please, can you be upstanding? We want to welcome you, all our pastors and bishops. Please just stand up. Let's celebrate them. Not only this way, if you are a pastor in the house, please, can you be upstanding? You are welcome, ma. We are welcome, ma. We recognize your presence because of time. We can't mention. Please, can we celebrate? That is the PDP State Chairman. You are welcome. We also have the Speaker of the House of Assembly. Please, Right Honorable Sherry Ogbewori. Please, can we celebrate our Speaker, Delta State? We also have the immediate past Speaker of the Delta State House of Assembly. Please join me to celebrate Right Honorable Monte Omigo Ikuya. He's in our midst. You are welcome, sir. We also have the number one citizen of the local government here in our midst. Please join me to make welcome Chief
Jesus' name. Please, at the reception, I'm sure we're going to be mentioning other names.
That is our assistant. Please don't celebrate the name. You are welcome, sir. Don't be offended.
Okay, we have the number one road woman in Delta State here in our midst. Please just permit me to recognize the number one road woman, Vice President General of the UPU, Urobo Progressive Union. I'm talking about Honorable Dr. Moses Tiger is in our midst. Please, can we celebrate? Daddy, you are welcome.
You are welcome.
Please, at the close of this funeral service here, we'll be on our way to Athletics Club. The instruction is this: if you don't have any business at the graveside, please find your way straight to Athletics Club where the reception will be taking place. Apart from the officiating personnel that will be officiating right there in the graveside, and family members, no other person apart than the chiefs. I'm sure they know themselves, the ones that ought to be there. Please, everybody.
Thank you.
sure that these are not sham. Just by the grace of God, yesterday, we will keep room for just only 3 persons. We have either something sham, testimony to give to our late father, just only 3 persons. And as you indicate, those are the ones that recognize and allow our father to bring them in. Balcony. Okay, we start with balcony.
Chief Senator David Dakunoni, OFR, could be described as a man who scaled the ladder of life to achieve greatness in all that he did, while exhibiting the ideals and values he held dear. Born on March 12, 1927 in Sapa Delta State, Senator David Dakunoni is the son of an ancient family that founded the Igbo Kingdom in the 15th century. His father was Chief Tom Omoya Dakunoni, who served as a judicial interpreter for the Judiciary Department in Sapa District. His mother managed a clothing business, but after his birth devoted her life to taking care of him. At the age of 7, he became a pupil at government school Benin from 1934 to 1938. He then transferred to Edo College and schooled there from 1939 to 1942. Between 1943 and 1945, he moved to Abeokuta Grammar School. On completing his secondary education, he emerged as the overall best candidate in mathematics in the Cambridge School Certificate Examination in West Africa. After completing his secondary education, he decided to venture to the north of Nigeria, joining the civil service in the northern region, which was based in Kaduna, on the 20th of August 1946. His work with the records of the service was to awaken his interest in finance and accounting, as he was made responsible for preparing budget estimates. The quality of his work, together with his academic record, was to later win him a scholarship from the then governor, Lieutenant Governor of Northern Nigeria, L.H. Gogo, to further his studies overseas. It was also the making of lifelong friendship with Alhaji Khan Saleh, Alhaji Sute Katanu, and Alhaji Aminu Saleh. All of them were to rise to the apex of their professions. Senator Dakunoni spent 2 years between 1951 and 1953 at Exeter University, where he obtained a diploma in public administration. He proceeded to and graduated from the University of London with a Bachelor of Science degree in economics in 1958. He was subsequently articled to a firm of chartered accountants, Messrs. J. A. Miles and Co. in the City of London, where after succeeding in his professional exams, qualified as a member of the Institute of Chartered Accountants in England and Wales in 1963. He became a fellow of both the Institute of Chartered Accountants in England and Wales and the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Nigeria in 1970. During this period, he met a young West Indian lady who had qualified as a nurse and was rising through the medical profession in 1957. It was to be the start of a 62-year devoted partnership and marriage, fulfilling all of the love, respect, care and devotion. It was with her blessing that they moved back to Nigeria in August 1963. Having established Jill Dakunoni & Co., now Howard Dakunoni, a firm of chartered accountants in 1966, the firm is now one of the largest accounting firms in Nigeria and is associated with the Kroll Group, which has over 5,000 employees and an estimated global revenue in excess of 500 trillion. His distinguished public service career saw him commence his contribution to the service of the federal government with appointments such as the Special Commissioner to investigate the assets of public officers in the Midwest states then of Nigeria in 1967 and 1968, and as a federal government arbitrator under the Fourth Amendment Act in 1969. In apparent appreciation of his diligence and commitment to service, Senator Dakunoni was again appointed in 1970 to serve as one of the three commissioners on the Apapa Road public tribunal to investigate the affairs of Mufati Denizel. The recognition of his devotion to his country led in the 1970s to being appointed to the position of Director of the Central Bank of Nigeria from 1971 to 1976. He also served as the director of various public and private companies between 1971 and 1979. Companies which he served as a member of the board included BMAC for BYP, as they were known at the time. He also established CD Corporation for the purpose of investing in land and property. The call to his service for his people came in 1979, and as responsive as ever, he accepted and was elected as a senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, representing former Bendel South, now Delta Central, in Delta State Senatorial Zone, where he served as chairman of Senate Committees on Commerce, Industries, National Planning and Steel Development between 1979 and 1983. He was elected for a further term in 1983. With the overthrow of the government in 1983, he then returned to the private sector, and his performance in various assignments further facilitated his appointment in 1987 as a consultant to carry out a detailed organizational, financial, technical and management review of the country's steel mills with a view to providing information for their partial privatization and commercialization. As a man with strategy for troubleshooting, he was also appointed to arbitrate a dispute between the Nigerian Security Prince and Mitri Family Limited and Thomas De La Rue Limited of the United Kingdom to ascertain amounts payable to the latter. Between 1990 and 1991, Senator Daphneli was appointed as a consultant to the federal government to source funds for the completion of the Lagos Third Mainland Road Project, while serving as a committee member to review the administration of indirect taxation in Nigeria. In 1992, Senator Daphneli was asked to join the Northern Elders Forum, a non-partisan group that gave independent political advice to governments believing that we needed to all work together to build our nation. Together with gentlemen such as the late Alhaji Abdulrahman of Benin and Dr. M.T. Umbu, the group provided independent advice for vital national interests were at stake over the period from its foundation until the commencement of democracy. Senator Daphneli stands out as the personification of the need for justice and equity with no regard to all aspects of the Niger Delta. He was President of the Union of Niger Delta, a non-governmental organization whose objectives are the sustainable development of the Niger Delta. He also invested in and went into joint venture industries with multinationals in the establishment of two industries in roofing materials and rubber processing in Sapo local government area. These enterprises provided economic opportunities to the people of Sapo to lift themselves out of poverty. His humanitarian and selfless service manifested in various forms, including his pivotal role in the construction of the Oruju Ogunbowale Palace, a property since completed at a cost of over 100 million naira. He also functioned as the chairman and patron of various bodies in the Ogun Kingdom. In recognition of his immense and selfless contributions to the socio-economic and political development of the Ogun Kingdom, he was honored in 1997 with the traditional title of Ogoye One of Ogoye Kingdom by the Ruji of Ogoye. The award, an award of the Certificate of National of Excellence for Professional Practice by the then Delta State Government, was also given to Senator Daphneli in September 1997. In 2001, he was awarded the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Nigeria Certificate of Merit for outstanding contributions to the accounting profession by the Institute. And in 2003, the federal government conferred on him the national honor of the Officer of the Federal Republic, OFR. He has always been moved by the plight of the less privileged in society. Senator Daphneli, after leasing the late Pat Torrey, became a chairman of the Pat Torrey Memorial Trust to himself to ensure support to mentally handicapped children. A few years ago, he, alongside with the American Women's Club in Nigeria, laid the foundation of the permanent complex of the home, which when completed will remain an enduring legacy to society. This concern for the poor has also led to the establishment of the Dakinoni Foundation, which provides seed capital at the micro level to women in Sapling, enabling them to also get themselves out of poverty. As a versatile player, Senator Dakinoni was a member of various international organizations. He was a member of the Urban Land Institute of America, an organization with an asset value of over $93 trillion. Since 1992, and was elected to the Public-Private Partnership Council of the same body in November 1994. He was also elected a fellow of the National Geographical Society of Great Britain in 1990. In August 2000, Guinness World Records recognized Senator Dakinoni as the patriarch of the family, with the highest number of chartered accountants who are members of the Institute of Chartered Accountants in England and Wales in one nuclear family, a recognition that has received a profound ovation from far and wide. Senator David Omoya Dakinoni left us to our earthly lives on the morning of 30th September 2018, leaving behind his soulmate, Chief Mrs. Cynthia Dakinoni, his children, Igbo, Ide, Dugie, Oteri, and Joy, and his grandchildren, Isabel, Philip, Philippa, Hannah, Antonia, Samantha, Monica, and Amy. Thank you.
His role, as has been told us today, in his contributions to the building of the palace of the region of Okwen. Then we were much younger, but we heard a lot about him. Shows his concern for the people. I'm reading today about the Kakunone Foundation for the Lord's Sprinting, the Lodin Society. That is something that is very heartwarming. And I believe that his life has thrown a challenge to those of us that live. Because at the end, when we are departed, what will we be remembered for? As we live our daily lives, this must constantly come into our consciousness. At the end of time, when the Lord has called us home, what will we be remembered for? I'm glad that Papa, here lying in state at the moment, is gone. But he will be remembered for a lot of good things. It's a charge to each and every one of us to please try to be the light that is worthy, the light that will touch the lives of others, particularly those who are in need. We must learn to be our brothers and our sisters' keepers. In all that we do, we must consider others along with ourselves. It's not enough to stay with your nuclear family. I believe he has a very exciting nuclear family, but he felt the need to reach out to his people. And I'm sure that that is why a lot of us are out here this morning to pay our last respect. It is my hope that the Lord will receive his soul in heaven. I must condole with the family. Yes, it's gone. But because of the kind of life he lived and the age at which he departed, actually, it is a time to celebrate his life. But I want to urge the family, the fact that Papa is departed, they must recall that home is home, and they must continue to relate with the home base. Because no matter what you achieve outside, if your impact is not felt in your home, you have virtually achieved not too much. We are glad that you returned Papa here, and that you're here with a lot of people. Even as I came into the church now, I'm sorry I came in late. I already see that a lot of people are already going towards the reception ground, which is going to take place hours away from now. That shows that the people love you, and the people can only love you when truly you have made some impact on the society back home or in their personal lives. As I condole with you and the whole of your kingdom, it is my hope that all of us seated here in the church will continue to remember that on the last day, you will only be remembered for that of which you have done. If it is good, God will receive you. If it is not good enough, then you will have some query to answer. But only God knows the hands that have done that. May God bless the people of this church. May God bless the family of Senator Chief David Kakunone. And as you feel the impact of our departed father, may the Lord encourage you and fill the gap that he has left behind. God bless you.
All that is linked to me, paternally, known as police, our late father, this time I'm going to pray for you. As I read the birthday of Igwebu, the citizens of David Dafino, had made a mark, distinguished himself in his field of endeavor. And Lord, I pray for the children in their various field of endeavor.
may they also discipline themselves in the name of Jesus. Eternal Father, we pray that the children will live a better life than their father. In the name of Jesus, we cover the entire family with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Is it not the one who is at the table, but I am among you as one who says, this is the word of the Lord. The God Almighty bless his words into our hearts in Jesus' name. God bless you all. Thank you. Be seated.
Of human beings. You are the creator of heaven and earth. help us this time to understand who we are, where we are, and where we are going from here, that we may rejoice and have hope that our tomorrow shall be better than today. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. Luke chapter 22, verse 27 has a very significant impression on my life, and I guess it should be a reminder to every one of us that is seated here this moment. In Genesis chapter 1 verse 1, the Bible says, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. At the creation of heaven and earth, there were no human beings. No ant was alive. No fish, no animal was alive to give instructions or directions to God on how it should have its mold. No human being, no kingdom was available to direct the culture and the tradition we should have in that setting. He created the world, He created the seas, He created the forest, He created the ants, the flies. No human being. The animals He created, no human being. But at last, God said to Himself, let us make man in our image and let them have dominion, supervision over all creatures. Genesis 1:27 says, so God created man in His own image. In the image of God created him, male and female. Thus, the beginning of any human being became a supervisor of God's creation. Man is a supervisor of God's creation. And the wisdom also to supervise God's creation was given to the man by God. In Genesis chapter 2 verse 7, the Bible says that God created man like a carved image or a molded image on the ground. The man had no motion. He didn't know where he was. And he couldn't have instructed or directed or informed or suggested to God what would make him become a human being. But God, in Genesis 2:7, raised that block of sand up and breathed into him the breath of life. Thus man became a living soul. So our abilities, both senior and junior, educated and military or civilians, pastors or not, we are here. All of us that are here this morning are alive to speak and hear as a result of that godly endowment. And the moment that breath is removed from whosoever, king or slave, it becomes a waste. As I pass the roads daily and see mad men, mad women, naked along the road, I look at myself in them. What is the difference between me and this mad person? It's because that the wisdom of God remains in me and still directing remove the bread from a madman, from a king, all of us become the same thing. You either waste them. I will not forget about the year 2000 at PTI Junction. A vehicle ran into a mad person in the night, and the mad woman died. Mad person died. Nobody buried that person. Vehicle passed and crushing day and night until they grinded the whole human being into sand. Nobody buried. The local government did not. It remained the head. And nobody could pick it from the road and bury until the vehicle came one day, smashed one side, and it jumped to the other side. As I passed each day on that road, I look at myself. Who am I? If I had died like this person, vehicle could mash me like this up and down. Will I be aware of it? I wouldn't be aware that I'm being grounded to powder, because what made me to be a living soul has left me. And so, man lived by the order of God for a while. The two holiest persons that the world have ever produced is Adam and Eve. They lived in holiness. They lived according to God's instructions. And they were not to die. There was no death. No death. Because God does not die. He that he has made in his own image must not think of death. And so, God gave instructions very distinctly to the man and the woman concerning just a tree and the fruit. Don't eat this fruit. The day you eat it, you shall surely die. Adam and Eve had never known anything about death. Nothing around them had died, save the animals and the fishes they caught for food. And the death of the fishes and the animal does not mean to them the death of human beings. But while they were there, the Bible taught us the enemy of God, which was not known by Adam and Eve, accosted the woman and said to her, "What did God say?" And the woman answered, "God said, don't eat this fruit. The day you eat it, you shall surely die." And the serpent said to the woman, "God is a liar." Today, many of us are still calling God liars. Among us that are here this morning, I can say if not 99% of us, I still calling God liar. We don't want to obey what God said. It is what we have determined we will do. It happened in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 44 from verse 16. God upbraided the children of Israel. Don't worship idols. Don't bake cakes for sacrifice. Jeremiah told them, and they told Jeremiah back, "What God sent you to tell us, we will not do. One tell you, we will not do it. But when we are making sacrifices to our idols, then we have peace and our crops yielded. We have a popular celebration in Nigeria today called Yam Festival. It's still on. There are many festivities amongst us as human beings, which we carry out against the will of God, even in our educated position, in our leadership position. We don't care when it is time to disobey God, everyone is free. They disobey God, boha, we are still doing it now. And because of that singular character, death entered into human beings' life. Man who was not to die, the image of God, began to die. like we have our father here in the casket here. I wouldn't believe that he'll be here. Agadabai, when he stands up, things are done. Anywhere he stands, there is covering for others. If he talks of money, he will provide the money. If you talk of words representation, he will represent us with words. He is more than 20 people when he stands up to the jail. But now, here he lies, his 30th of September, when I was called by the chairman of Sapele community, that our daddy had rested. I shouted, "Hey!" My mind went to Chibokoko. Who will take the position of Yogi? My mind went to Professor Nyewari, who is here to stand the gap for Open Kingdom. Death is an enemy to human being. It's not God's will that any man should die. So we should not venerate death. It's our enemy. Because Adam and Eve disobeyed God by eating the fruit, it has transported, made any and every human being on earth today to be dying. Even a foetus died. It pains me that human being died. But God, at the same time, arranged a rescue for us. Because when God quenched the woman for eating the fruit, she said she was deceived. I know deception can do many evil things in humanity. And so God proposed to give us a Redeemer. And this Redeemer came in the person of Jesus Christ. And it is this Jesus who came to this earth, saw all of us, the way we are behaving in managing our leadership position, the way people were struggling to kill one another, to acquire, to occupy. Men did not know that the character of seizing people's properties is a negation to life. It is deep in practicing today. This is principal of a secondary school. This is principal of a secondary school. Husband and wife. Coming for the chairmanship of Oredo local government. In the morning, the woman will prepare akara from the same house. He and the husband were living in the same house. They go on their campaign trip from the same house. Arguments upon arguments, threats upon threats on his life. The devil did not want man to be free from the shackles he had given unto us in the Garden of Eden through our parents. He planned the assassination of Jesus Christ about 70 times, from pregnancy down to the actual death. God kept Jesus for us to learn from, because God to lead us. What do we find from the leadership today? After 58 years of independence, Nigeria cannot have a stable life. We don't even have water to drink anymore. In 1958, when I used to come here to buy my disciples, there was a public tap along the road here, on Cemetery Road. If you are thirsty, you go to the tap and drink water. There is no public tap in Nigeria where you drink water. And yet we pay for water more. Where is our service to our nation? When you travel abroad last night, we were going back to the hotel. The new road junction was blocked. And I told the occupants with me in the vehicle, if this were to be Israel, even at 4 a.m., you have free passage because it is controlled by light. The light that was constructed there died at the inception, and it cannot be resuscitated. When is service in our nation? And Jesus said, who is greater? Is it the man that is sitting on the high table with fork and knife and spoon to cut the chicken? Is it the greatest? But that is what we regard in Nigeria as the greatest. If you are not called to the high table, you are anointed. Why am I not recognized? My God, I recognize you. God, when I recognize you, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. But not the devil, I recognize you. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. All our elders, I recognize we are natives here. This is the only country we have as our own. And if things are not working well, should we not tell ourselves that things are not working well? These things are not working well. There are flights for 50 naira in America. Now 50 naira you can fly. From here to Warri, 50 naira. Plane. I go and pass between here and Warri now. Your shock absorber will give way on the road. This is an oil producing state. The money is pouring away from here. And nothing is done for the people. And this is Sambala itself. Drive around and see whether service is being rendered to this town. What are we doing to ourselves? Ladies and gentlemen, it is good I hurt some people so that you can repent and do something. Because the end is not in the position we are holding. You read from what our brother read, you read with him as he was reading. All that our father attained while he was here with us. With all those attainments, if it were to be a matter of money to buy debt, he only has money to buy debt. He would have bought it. Not that. There's money to buy, both home and abroad. Whether pounds or dollars, he only has money to buy. I stood by the graveside of Michael Ibro with my governor. And I saw this giant of money being lowered like this into a pit. And I said to myself, is this the end of a rich man? If this is the end of riches, then why should somebody struggle to become rich? And at the end of it, you'll be locked up. You'll not be hearing anybody. DOD is not hearing me now. What a shame of life. Then after that, we are going to put him into one little round house and then lower it to the grave. We are going to throw flowers. Does he need flowers? Does he need the flowers? He doesn't need them. So what are we doing for service? Jesus said, who is greater? Who is greater? Is it the man that sits on the high table or the one that serves? And he said unto them, I am come among you as one that serves. If God becomes a servant in the culture and tradition of living, then whose culture are we like? He is the only creator of heaven and earth. He created us. Where did we find the culture, tradition, lifestyle of embezzlement, and the worst of it, carrying the money from Nigeria to hide in another country? We go there to ride on their carros, but here the road to our village is potholes. What wickedness is this? This is not good for us. DLC with over 10,000 employees is done. Our boys are now Okada riders, PhD holders. They ride Okada. As if that is not enough, they have created courtesy for them. Give them power to kill one another. We kill one another, develop our nation. With guns, develop our nation. We have been able to block the countries that have supplied Boko Haram guns. We are calling for money to help rebuild the broken. What about those who supply them the guns? Don't we know that? That's business. Since that is business, they give you the contract to buy guns. And from there, you make it. What are we making is selling guns to make people to die. Three stages I want to give to you and we close. And I close from here. The first stage of this world is that you are created. By creation, I mean you are born by your parents into a world that was already saturated with evil. Yes. We are born into the evil. I was born into it. The oldest man here this morning is 100 years, we are told. He was born into it. He's still alive. So he's suffering the things that we are suffering. Now those of us who are born medievally into it, we are also experiencing the kind of thing that the devil wished that the world should have. But in the midst of it, Jesus came and said unto us, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. This Jesus has become the medium for our destiny. In 1 John chapter 4, chapter 5, verse 11 and 12, John told us, this is the record that God has given unto us, eternal life. Eternal life. And this life is in his Son. He that has the Son has life. And he that has not the Son has no life. So the opportunity available here this morning, as you hear me, is that you believe in Jesus Christ. Don't call it a religion. Christianity is not a religion. Christianity is God's means of helping us to escape the future damnation, which anybody could fall into. Anybody could fall into it. You find the testimony of the man that was very rich with Lazarus in the book of Luke. He was feeding sumptuously on the earth here. Lazarus was living at his gate, struggling with crops that had thrown away. But at death, he found himself in hell. It is real, brethren. Hell is
real.
Whether you believe it or not. You were not there when you were created yourself. You cannot tell your mother, how did you know that you give birth to me? You can't ask your father questions concerning your being. When you were foetus in your mother's womb, did you know? When you become a human being, did you know? Medical doctors are here. Do you know how these fingers get formed in the womb of our mothers? Do you know how your eyes get formed in the womb of your mother? Can you tell your mother, how did my head become this? Can you argue it? You cannot. You are not. And you will not. Then he called his own name. Lord Jesus. I have had. Not only now.
I have had it before.
That you came.
To die.
To save me.
I have looked down.
On the testimonies.
Yeah.
Oh, Watch your back.
Where did they go? Watch your back.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
Who be that now? Just now, come on now. I'm going to come back.
Just now, give somebody a chance.
Now and forevermore.
Amen.
Peace be to you all.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So we are through with this section. We are going for the reception.
Asa kanyo, 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 asa kanyo Hot, hot. Like I said before, the former Deputy Governor of Delta State, His Excellency Amos Ago Tuoma, right here. In fact, I want to thank you for taking time to be here, considering it as a matter of exigency, to share your indispensable commitment, I hope, to be here. It is quite one thing to be educated, and another thing to be culturally enlightened. If you are educated without the corresponding level of cultural enlightenment, to galvanize the education you have acquired, you find mediocrity still featuring your daily activities that may result in your parochial assessment of situations. In the case of His Excellency, he is quite educated, and as well culturally enlightened. I appreciate you, sir. I know this woman who showed residence is never captured. For them, it's all the time prepared. It's not allowing himself to be weighed down in any form. That is why he's remaining unruffled and undaunted all the time. I want to appreciate you as well. That is Jesus, he realizes that he is a fool. That is the day he is no longer a fool. I am happy that we have our people here. And this state continues to feature. And I am happy.
If you go outside, they won't let you in again.
We are sending back and thank you. All the children of TOD Dafirima should come on the floor. The children of TOD. Why the children cannot come around, ladies and gentlemen? And we answer. When it seems like you is not the benefit to me, I just want to say that you are wrong. See, I'm living like a ghetto for my ghetto. Never forget where I come from, no, from ghetto. Oh, no, 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 no. I just want to say that you are wrong. We're going to reward you, go back.
And we thank God for today. We are celebrating a great man. Chief Dafinone lived a life worthy of emulation. What a man, to a very large extent, put food on people's table by establishing a lot of industries across the breadth, length and breadth of the world. A man violently progressive. A man who touched virtually everybody around him positively. A man who trained his children to the level that he entered the Guinness Book of Records as a man whose children, all of them, were chartered accountants. So he left a very big legacy worthy of emulation. The shoe he has left behind, I don't know whether the children slept big enough to enter the shoe. May God, now to pray to God to give us so many other Dafinonis among his children, among Sapele people, among Delta people and Edo people. May God continue to protect him.
Thank you very much. I wish you the best of life. Happy weekend.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. In fact, if my wife gives birth to another child, I will call name that child Dafinoni. My God,
please.
See you, 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 see you,
company and leader. Thank you. Ologu customers, Ibrahim, we greet you. High Chief Tunde Spood, the Malaway of the Niger Delta is in the house. Why is this time? Last week, Saturday, we had it together. No, Thursday in Lagos. The way of the Niger Delta, we greet you. High Chief. First, the next minister, the man who was able to charge of drinks and food, make them available for people to drink, because in that funeral night they prepare for today. Already they walk out, they move it. You see how they go? Give it up here. If you are distributing drinks, there should be no bias. In fact, you should not marginalize. Subline.
give to everyone right here, because I want to believe one thing. If you have no food, no drink, right, as we are here, I want to assume you did not come here with your destiny. Probably that is why you have that problem. But I will teach that determines exactly when it pulls up. Otherwise, tobacco takers would have been toothless by now. And I want to say that is the time that I stand for you.
Thank you. You are my
Ladies and gentlemen, did they hold it? If the Avellana children gave their father a befitting burial, on that note, shake somebody and say you are blessed.
In the place of Avellana, they are champions. They are champions. They are champions. In the place of Avellana, they are champions. They are champions. It is well planned. It is well executed. They are all champions. Champions, champions, champions.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, wherever you are seated, take off your property, because some people already pickpocketing and taking what does not belong to them. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, the little children are happy, shaking people around, say you are too much. Now, guarantee the occasion, anything you want to do, or for insurance, if it is not now, it cannot be like that.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We appreciate every one of you. If you live at the river bank and you find a madman there, take your bag of time, come out of the river to put on your clothes. If you allow the madman to
all along and you are seen with us here, I appreciate you.
If you are not presentable in your photograph and you are holding the photographer responsible, I want to tell you that that is an oppression. Because how you look in that photograph is a true reflection of how you look physically. If it is a lie, act accordingly. Thank you. God bless you.
All right, DJ. All right, over to you. Let's hear you.
So that you can prevent it from undergoing
I am God Afinone, the wife of Eden Afinone. These are our people. This is Eden Afinone. I'm here to see you, tell your people. Ambassador of Mrs. Victoria Godo in the house. A daughter of G.O.D. Afinone, first executive. National Secretary of the Control Institutional Agency, Honorable the Minister of Health, different ministries, that's the one. These are our people, our family. We are not going to go to the bottom. What I can do. You don't go. I'm actually your brother, Granorator, greet you. What's it? Skido! As a loser. Now you can sing for natural patronage. That is a special commitment. An encouragement. Just for the development of the tradition and culture of the Canada. Our fatherland must be maintained and preserved accordingly. Oh yes. For the pastor, I will not forget. Oh Lord, I'm going to have the couple. If I had what you represent to us, if missed by or lost by the father, we make them take up a committee society. But you have given it now, it's not the father. I appreciate it. Because you can see some element of prosperity. Oh yes! You can imagine then.
Even when I get down. When I go to the bar, go perform, I saw this performance. They find bands, but I challenge them for Calabar, say, to find a something you know, how much you can let go to, and I'm about to tell you, that's the one you take time. Only boss can I put a ticker. Who's DJ? Where is the ticker? You don't go back to the board. How's DJ say, my man, make a picker. Chairman with two local comrades in the house. Kidogo, I help you. The security group of OCJ group, I hail you. Honorable Cosmas. He has agreed to the political currency that says in God we trust. Mrs. Edna Davinure, let Davinure change you to come and spread them because it's not easy. Executive Band, I greet you. Sammy and Jay, make drinks available to the Executive Band to drink because they're wonderful. Sammy and Jay. You are too much. Recognize the executive. OCJ Ibru. OWC. Otupa. Hey, Omashini. These are the big shots. Omashini of the Roba Plantation. Roba Group. If you don't know the Amachi, you will know. OCJ Master Group, the first son of the Lord of the Kingdom. I'm not going to work.